Yo, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode of The Greatest. This is my FIFA 23 career mode series, which is also a road to glory. And we are going to be starting off, we're actually going to be playing our first games as Southampton manager after recently being appointed. Last episode, obviously, was the first official one of us being appointed as Southampton manager. But today is the first games. We obviously made the team, made the squad, and to be fair, that's it. That's a team that can compete in the Premier League. I don't know how we're going to do, but it is a team that we assembled for like £300 million. Sancho and Sane on the wing. We've got Felipe Coutinho. Yes, he's coming to the end of his career and he's not as good as he once was, but I'm sure he'll do a job for us. I have done the necessary things that I needed to do, like edit the players, looks and everything. But the first five games we're going to have a look at now. We know that Brighton is the first game. Then we're away to Leeds. The good thing about being in the Premier League is every team has their own ground. So it's just going to make it so much better. So we have Brighton at home, then we're at Leeds away, then we're in the Cup to Crawley Town, so it's a Cup, but there's going to be more Cup games this season, and then we're at home to Aston Villa, and then our fifth game is away to Manchester City. It's going to be our first real test. It could be our first ever loss in the series. One thing I want to address, and because I'm recorded a few in advance, about a week's in advance, I don't know what happened to episode 20, which would have been the first episode of season 3. I do apologise, but there is a gap between, so there's no episode 20. I'm almost sure, like, I'm pretty sure that I, recorded everything. It's just, I wonder if it just got blocked and copyrighted. I have no recollection of it, which is crazy. But anyway, it doesn't matter too much. Luckily, it was in a season where nothing really too much needed to happen. But yeah, I'm baffed by it. But anyway, it doesn't matter. We're at Southampton now, and we are going into our first pre-match conference.
We'll be starting with the questions now.
Yes, the players are easily good enough to get into the mid-table. He'll prove this. Obviously, but in the first few episodes, it's going to ask us like about players, about when are they going to make their debut, such like that. So
okay,
it is. But by after the Crawley game, we should have played everyone that's in the squad, I would have thought. I love how it still like shows us news about New York. Liverpool versus Man United in the first game of the Premier League. I want better than that. I wanted to push for Europe with the team, but we've got. But anyway, let's get into the first game. Oh my god, I can't believe it's like reset all this. It actually got to the point where it reset and it thought that I needed to look at the terms and conditions of FIFA. Just because my battery went flat and it turned my control off. Crazy that. Right, we're changing the kits. They can play an alternate. I think that would be the best idea. I just realised that Brighton came up from the playoffs. So, also, another thing I need to do. The ball is on default. I'm glad it's actually changed that. Ah, now in the Premier League, it actually... No, wait. It shouldn't be random. Why is it on? Why is it doing this? When it reset, it must have reset everything. No way is it changed all this. I have no idea what my camera is. Why has it done this? I don't know what I play on. What the fuck do I play on? Is it telebroadcast I play on? I have no idea. I have seriously no idea. Radar off. Oh my god, it's actually... Okay, that's kept that the same. I have no idea. We're going to have to play it by ear. But anyway, let's get into the first game of the episode.
Ushering in a new era at the club. Can he bring fresh ideas? We're about to find out. Stay with us on EA TV.
St. Mary's Stadium. I'm back in England, baby.
We've dropped anchor here on the south coast of England at St. Mary's Stadium.
I actually want to see... I have no idea. Is that zoomed in too much, do you think? I want to say it's like... Oh, that really doesn't change much. It's not telly, surely. I have no idea.
And I'm joined for...
That looks so odd. What on earth do I play it on? I think it's telebroadcast, but like... I'm gonna say it's like...
Expert analysis by my partner Stuart Robson.
That doesn't look right to me, but... Oh, it's got the fucking name bars at the bottom. I'm going to take all zoom out. So that worked then. Nice. I won't call that much zoom. but yeah, visual. Indicator.
It's Southampton facing
Brighton. I think that's fine. Well, the atmosphere is maybe I am on more default now on telebroadcast. This seems about right, I think. Oh!
Is it going to be? Oh, good work by the keeper.
I don't know if it's right. I don't know what it's done to reset all my stuff. Come on, Mbolo. The first goal of the Southampton era. The Saints era. And it is Breel Mbolo.
Well, here's the replay. It's certainly a well-delivered ball into the area, which makes it a fairly simple finish in the end. It's a really good goal.
That's a banging header, you know. Let's have a look at that again. We should win this game because... like I say, it's Brighton got promoted with us. Look at this. Oh, look at him. Stretch legs. Oh, yes. Why is he like that? That's a banging header, you know. Yeah, this seems alright, camera-wise. It's actually odd not seeing Southampton in, like, predominantly red. Oh my god. Oh my god, what even happened there? Right, hang on a sec. Auto clearances off. Auto shots off. What is happening to us? Time finishing off, that's the main thing. Auto flare pass. Sure. I wonder if that's why.
Not the best clearance.
I don't know if it's just a placebo effect, but me thinking this camera angle has been messed. I'm on number 9 now. I've just realised something. Customise controls. No, that's fine. So also, I'm so confused. Mbolo again. Fuck. Whoa. I can't believe I'm in the Premier League. Alright, come on, let's keep control of this. Yes, no ho. This is why I said you are, oh, you're more than an MLS player. You're absolutely fantastic. Leroy's starting position is a bit left to be desired. Oh. Highly promising, but they got nothing out of it. And the counter attack is on. Options available. And he might be through here. It was an excellent example of how to break at pace. Attacking football at its best. They switch on so quickly when they win the ball back. It deserved the goal. Yeah, it's definitely tele broadcast. And if the settings don't change that much, then I know that it's about this. Oh, you know what? I need to cross the ball more. With New York Red Bulls, I hardly ever crossed. Except for obviously corners. You know what? Even just the play right now is just so much quicker in the Prem. Jesus Christ.
Still behind here, but only due to some incredible goalkeeping. Surely it's only a matter of time if they keep quiet.
Are their names really that small normally?
Sané, in with a chance.
Oh!
And a no nonsense clearance.
Wait, I actually don't know if handballs is on there. Are their names really that small normally? No way, are they? I'm just loading up one of my old videos. Actually, to be fair, it should have been from a bit further ago. And my laptop wants to be a bit... Let's load up whatever one is my newest one. Maybe my icons are big. They are quite big, you know, maybe.
A referee playing advantage here.
They're bigger than that. But one thing I will say, camera wise, I think the height is might be like that. Visual. That's large, really? Play name. Am I just tripping? Maybe I'm more zoomed in than that normally. That's better. Turns out that
well, there we have
turns
it.
Out I do have them on large. I couldn't tell you what my thing was there. Anyway, let's not detract from the point anymore.
Well, as they get the ball rolling again. Interesting to see how the second half pans out.
Nice.
Can they do something positive on the counter attack?
Yeah, this seems about right. Sancho, you've got to score. Come on, 2-0.
I'm very white. That's better.
Every point is valuable in this league.
Almiron using his physical strength to shield it.
Yes, Zuna.
Oh, a superb
nice,
save.
Nice, nice, nice. One more.
Well, Leicester fans have been wondering, would the deal go through? It is now official. They've got their man, Stuart.
Yes, it's an exciting move for him, and hopefully we'll now see the best of him. But he'll need to settle in quickly to win over the fans. The move suits everybody, I think.
Jaden.
Real defensive resilience. Coutinho, ready to...
Coutinho with a header now. And Polo.
Get it away properly.
Indeed. Right, let's make some... subs. Let's take off Sane. No, you know what? We're thinking about.
Not a time for cool heads. Almiron.
Shit.
Looking threatening.
What a save again.
Oh, a stellar piece of defending.
Let's go.
And into the last 20 minutes. Oh, good vision. Could be troublesome.
Save my Sherpa.
Who can they pick out?
Where?
Joel Feldman. Oh, they've lost it. Now potential danger. And
oh, what a save. What a save, what a save. Right. Swap them around now. And then let's also bring on Talisa. God, my defenders have had to do a lot of running. But I'm actually very happy so far. Oh, shit. That's yours. Oh, it's offside. Ah!
So and cash with it. Options in the center.
You can definitely tell the difference between the Premier League and MLS.
Well, visionary passing.
Let's not take this for granted.
Ben Woodburn back with Tolisso. Way up. Surely.
Come on. Callum Hudson-Odoi, you know. Come on. First game at St. Mary's. First win at St. Mary's.
Just look at the quality of the cross. It's inch perfect. And then what a great finish as well.
To be fair, this is a game we should win.
Leaving the keeper with little chance. It's a great goal.
Come on. I know obviously we're faffed about with like settings and stuff, but I hope it's sort enough. I don't know why it reset. Should have done a bit better there. But I'm very happy because Mbolo scored, Hudson-Odoi scored, Sancho scored. Tim got a assist. So did Felipe. So did Nuhu.
Hi, just a couple of questions for you.
He did fine. We got a clean sheet. I'm sorry, but these are fucking stupid. They're doing that'll absolutely fine. So shut up. Shut up. I can't believe... Some people are just never satisfied. Okay, at least we got that. So, but I do want to check on our settings. Match settings. It doesn't seem to see. Audio's fine. But one thing I am going to do quickly before we go into any more games is I'm going to check if handballs are on. It might have just reset. Handballs need to be on. As much as it frustrates me. Game settings. Handballs on. Yeah. Referee strictness default. Nice. I genuinely don't know why it reset them, but well, it is what it is. But one game for the Saints and one win for the Saints. Chelsea won 4-0. So United did win, they won 3-2 away at Anfield. Right, away to Leeds United. I actually want to wear the other kit. No, I will wear that because it's a darker one. I'm going to... I knew who played well, you know. Plus, we have a cup game in midweek, so stay as it is. But one thing I am going to do is hopefully turn off the rain. There we go. Crazy how it all changed, but I think we're back to normal now. I'm pretty sure we're back to normal. Right. Away at Elland Road. Tough place to go.
Well, no matter the weather, it's always a thrill to be here at Elland Road and delighted to be able to...
Oh, I like this dark kit. Means we're in business.
Gary Gray at the microphone and joining me for match commentary is Stuart Robson.
I played Leeds. To bringing you action from the Premier League. Yeah, you know what? I do like this camera angle. Even if it's different, I like it because I like seeing the crowd a tiny bit.
They played some attractive football, they looked fit, and they fully deserved the 3 points. Can they repeat that?
Leeds are a good team on their day.
That'll be a Leeds United throw in. Superb defensive judgment to end the attack.
Shit. Okay, Bazunu, you know, is a good keeper.
Well, they won't get too many opportunities today, so they have to capitalize.
Get it away, Jaden.
Like not the best clearance.
Don't mind that. Bola's got strength. And he's got fucking pace
well,
and power.
Well, will be the player to decide the outcome, to determine the course of events. No reason at all why it won't be this man, Stuart. What do you anticipate seeing from him?
Well, Derek, his outstanding is his pace. Not just over the first few yards.
Why is Leroy wearing gloves?
And that makes him so difficult to play against. Defenders are unsure whether to get tight or drop off. A dynamic player.
Zane in the middle.
I need to change him because I don't want him to hurt on my keeper.
Tyler Adams. Thuram. Oh, a perfectly timed pass. Oh, but he's done brilliantly to cut it out.
The thing is, do we have the maturity levels compared to other
possibilities inside the box? Really could be.
Oh, keep it alive, keep it alive. Oh, Melier is a great keeper.
Delivering it. Danger averted. Well, behind for another corner. A bit short with the clearance.
Stay with him, stay with him. Just lost him.
Another perfect position to read it.
Nice. He didn't put. There's a penalty. I didn't think he was in the box. I did see shirt grabbing. It's a soft penalty, I won't lie. Yes, I know how to do it.
Can he make it 1-0?
Okay, maybe it. Felipe shouldn't be on pens when he's got a stutter and a run up like that.
Can someone get on the end of this? Well, not the best clearance. Bella Kotchap. Oh, great attack.
Okay, he's got a bit of... just too close to the keeper both times. When it wouldn't.
So for Southampton, you have to say it was a great performance against Brighton and Hove Albion. How might this one go, Stuart?
That's yours.
Well, they were so clinical, weren't they? 3-0 fairly represents
the difference
between
the two teams.
Today might be another matter, though. Very difficult to split the two teams, at least on paper. It might just be that one bit of quality, a bit of magic that could be the difference.
Oh, hang on, Stuart. Big chance here.
Melier, man.
Move across and deal with the danger. He's driven in the corner.
Come on, Umbello. Zin! Yes! Come on! You know what? Cool celebration. Come on. I like this kit, you know. I like it a lot.
Well, as we can see again, it's a deep delivery into the box, which cuts out a lot of the defenders. And it's a comfortable finish in the end, which is made to look so easy.
Melia did so well. Nearly.
Well, the ball is moving once more. How important will that opening goal prove to be? And there we have it, the half-time whistle.
Okay, 1-0 at half-time. And Bella can stand a bit longer. He won't play against Crawley.
So back underway here, into the second half.
We'll bring in Rian and I'm going to have to learn his name. Over striker.
Not the pass he had in mind. And this news is hot off the press on the transfer front. I can tell you that Andreas Christensen has completed his move to Chelsea.
Yes, it's an exciting move for him, and hopefully we'll now see the best of him. But he'll need to settle in quickly to win over the fact.
Can't miss,
oh,
surely!
My God.
Oh, the keeper made it look routine. It was anything but.
Wait, can I turn that quick substitution thing off? Visual. I don't think I can. No, I can't. I will be able to at the end of the match, though. Right.
Well, it's been a while, but these fans are now coming to life. Can they equalise here?
They favoured a short one here. Brendan Aaronson.
Oh, shit. Thuram. This bit of skill here from him. Well, actually, it's just a pass through. Alan Rhodes is going nuts.
keeper, but really he only has himself to blame. And they continue to advance, and a lot of options here.
Well, the possession tells you everything. Nothing really to split between the two sides. It's been an enthralling encounter up to now, with both teams playing some really good expansive football. You just wonder if the coach will be looking at that and how they can tighten up at the back.
Oh, Stuart, they must score! And hit with ferocity, it was
missed. He's actually missed.
But not quite good enough.
Coming off the pitch, number 11, Leroy Sané. Number 10, Coutinho. And number 8, Curtis Jones. Coming onto the pitch, number 19, Callum Hudson-Odoi. Number 20, Ben Woodburn. And number 16,
Woodburn. Will he finish? It could be up for grabs. Well, an escape. It looked a certain goal.
Come on. No. How did he not get there?
Well, no let up. Plenty of pressure. Well, doesn't have to do it on his own. Way up. Can he put them ahead?
Oh, you...
He clears it out of harm's way.
Fucking shoot, man.
Well, you just never know about chances near the end. You've got to be opportunistic. Will this corner do it? Relatively straightforward to mop up defensively. And a body in the way. Ndidi. Hudson-Odoi. Getting forward. Woodburn must take the lead here.
Ah, you... I just can't do it. Oh.
Junior Firpo. Brendan Aaronson.
Shit.
Well, they still have designs on the wing.
Shit.
Still looking to get the shot off. Terrific block. And that is that.
We're going to have to settle for a draw.
The two teams couldn't be separated. What did you make of the first performance?
Damn it. Our first draw of points. But we are Southampton. We are Southampton. Gotta remember that. We were by far the better side, but let's be honest. One man stood above the rest, and his name is Melier. He's very, very good. Goal from Briel. An assist by Felipe again. We're going to have to endure this. We've gone. It's a huge step up from the MLS. We've got better players, yes, but...
Have you got time for any questions?
We need to improve. They gave everything. Like, I couldn't ask anymore. We made a couple of dodgy decisions, or I did, at least. Well, it's fine. We're learning. Where is he? Oh, yeah, he's still a close one. This is not what I meant. Actually, while I remember... Is it visual? I swear there is one. Quick substitutions, hide. I'm pretty sure that's everything. Pretty sure that's everything. Do I want Cade Gordon? I do, yeah. Just basically for any time we got a cup game, because otherwise my four wingers are going to get knackered. It's going to be nice to have a youngster in there. I can manage that. Oh, we've got to play leave at the same time. For how cheap we bought him 2.5 years ago. I'll take that. Right, the good thing about Cade is he's already in a position. Oh, what I mean. He's 19 and he apparently can't do anything. On him number 23. And then also make sure he's. We do get to see a few other players in this game. Yeah, both of these are going to be playing. Spot on, I think. Right, EFL Cup time. And then what, we're at home to Villa and then away to City.
Hello, a warm welcome. We've
draws like that against Leeds, though, are going to prevent us from achieving things. They're games that we have to win.
From the Carabao Cup, it's Southampton versus Crawley Town.
Well, the host surely we make light work of Crawley.
Better technical players and can be brilliant when everything clicks. But their opponents are well organised, resilient and pose a threat on the counter attack. Therefore, an early goal would be the main priority for the home team.
Do the thoughts at least.
Great form. And he's just pulled off
Dom Telford.
Stunning save there. That is brilliant. Let's see about the delivery. Not the result from the set piece they were looking for. And here's how the lineup looks for Southampton. Loris Karius is the goalkeeper. Corentin Tolisso starts with Ben Woodburn in central midfield. And as for the attack, well, it has a bold look about it with three forwards listed from the beginning.
Kind of killed the tempo there. Mm-hmm.
Can he get them in front? A powerful effort, but not threatening the goalkeeper.
Ah.
He'll be disappointed. Well, I'm sure
nice.
His heart is beating extra
nice
quickly
branding.
Because it's his debut game today. Stuart, what should we expect to see from him?
Well, he's certainly got pace. He'll also be expected to get forward when he can.
Yes, Ben. Come on.
Assessment of the situation at the back. Bodies forward and the break looks on.
Poor ball, but to be fair, Callum ran too.
Oh, that's a pass of
central.
Ably intercepted when it looked as though they might be in. Oh, getting the ball forward. Will he find the net? And a goal!
Come on, Ryan. First goal for Southampton.
and just look how quickly they break forward once they win the ball back. But there's still plenty to do from here. He hits it so well, though. Lots of pace, lots of power, and the keeper just can't react in time. It's a great strike.
So the ball rolling again. 2-0 the score. Williams.
So far, Ben has been everywhere. So this is what I want. Like, these are players I know. So they've been very good so far. I'm not surprised one bit, but they've both scored. That's yours, Lovie.
Well, approaching half-time on the home side, very much
played very nice so far.
Your thoughts?
Yes, it's been a really energetic display from them so far. The passing's been sharp, the movement from the front players has been excellent, and the finishing has been clinical. They will certainly be happy going in at half-time.
Ryan Brewster. And now Woodburn.
Ah.
Tremendous intuition to win it back. Well, that's a well-timed pass.
God, Telford has actually done very well against us.
Ben Woodburn. Hudson-Odoi. Well, the threat was very real. Marvellous defending.
2-0 at the break. Not bad, not bad. This is what we need just in the cup, just to have a game where we can actually play different sort of players. These two will play at some point. I feel like I need another, like, cam, but I don't have any money. Unfortunately, Coutinho just isn't that.
Way up. Teammates in the middle. And in the end, no damage done. Well, let's see what they have in store for them on the break. Will they profit from this situation? Could reduce the deficit. Really sound goalkeeping.
Well, that had to be a goal.
Fuck off, was that a save? That is.
They will now make use of the substitutes bench. Not quite the clearance they were hoping for. Nicely saved.
Ah. Right, let's make some subs. I've forgotten his name, Mara. I'm intrigued to see how Mara does. It's medium, medium.
Oh, really commanding goalkeeping. Well, we're into the final half hour. Woodburn. Now that pass easy on the eye. He might be able to make it through.
I could like this kid. I could really like him. I could really, really, really like him. Do you really like that? Really, really like that?
Smash it as hard as possible.
Oh, yeah.
Three goals without reply. Williams.
It's a good ball across. Oh.
To clear it away.
I could do with a centre mid, really. But it's not to worry.
Well, we wondered if this deal was going to be done. In fact, it has now been done, Stuart.
Well, the reported fee of around £55 million is, in my view, a good price.
£55 million for Zakaria.
So consistent. Let's hope he fits in quickly.
Magnificent defending.
And a throw. Let's get those subs on.
There has been been plenty of limbering up from substitutes, and now both sides will make personnel switches. Mason. Telford. And with that, the attack fizzles out. Can they hit on the break? Coutinho. Now with Zani. Is this the moment?
Oh, Cade. Unlucky, unlucky boy, unlucky. Don't worry about it. I like the British Cross font on the back of lower league sides.
Telford. Wonderfully weighted pass.
That's what's coming.
It was easy on the eye, but the interception was made. Plenty of support here. Oh, he's really opened them up here. Just needs to stay calm. A goal! An exceptional performance this. Four to the good now.
Well, here's the replay, and just look how quickly they break forward once they win the ball back. And there's certainly no doubt about the finish. He really hits it with power and accuracy. Nothing the keeper can do about that.
A lopsided contest, 4-0. Well, adding up all the stoppages, we will have 3 extra minutes. Well, nicely cut out. Now, what can they do with the ball? And that's it, the final whistle.
That's a beautiful win.
The hosts will go through.
Well, what a good attacking display that
would be. Nice if we can have a cup run. Obviously, at this stage of my career, I've won everything there is to offer. That's not going to happen at Southampton. Surely, at least. So, Morrow with 2 goals. Rian Brewster with a goal. 1 goal, 2 assists from Woodburn. An assist by Brendan Williams as well. Top draw. That's how... what we needed after the Leeds game. But I'm not dwelling on the Leeds game. I thought felt like their goal was good and we just couldn't score. What do you mean he's not living? He got man of the match. They got a bloody clean sheet. Yeah, let's do that for a game.
Thanks so much for your time.
No problem. Who? Oh, no. It is deadline day. Curtis Jones, Conor Bradley. Nice. Okay, let's go. Aston Villa next. To be fair, they could wear their home kit. This is why these players are but it's an international break, so it's not the end of the world anyway. So far, Mbolo's got 2 games, 2 goals.
The man to watch.
Wow.
Facing his former club, he'll want to make a point live on EA TV.
Mike Cash is great, sick of golf for though.
Hello, a warm welcome. We've dropped anchor here on the south coast of England at St Mary's Stadium. I'm Derek Ray in the commentary position, and I'm joined for expert analysis by my partner Stuart Robson. And looking forward to bringing you action from the Premier League coming right up. It's Southampton up against Aston Villa.
Well, Derek, I have to say,
did I underestimate the Premier League?
For their first couple of matches, they're unbeaten.
I don't know.
Looked a very good team. But I still think they can
Leeds were very good at defending.
They put in a big performance today.
I keep getting notifications, but I don't know if it's like notifications or just little updates.
Tyrone Mings plays with Diego Carlos in central
defense. don't panic with it.
Of a strike partnership.
Good.
That's the kind of shielding play you expect from him.
What the hell? Coutinho against his old team.
That there's been a goal at Stamford Bridge. Let's hear all about it from Alex. Alex, sorry to interject, but a big chance here.
Yes. He is here to revitalize his career. 100%.
Attack is so impressive. And then from there, the keeper has got the chance. 2-on-1, left completely exposed. And
come on.
A simple finish in the end.
It wasn't working out at United under in the spotlight. So I've given him a way out.
Well, apologies to Alex.
And he will become the greatest winger of all time.
Just to clarify, Chelsea did find the net in that game. And their lead stands at 1-0 presently. Now options are plenty. Well, visionary passing. But in fact, he's taken up an offside position.
Oh, that's frustrating. He just took too long to see the pass.
Sané able to get a body in the way. Curtis Jones. Oh, good looking run. That's well blocked. Corner conceded. It came off the defender. And fed in by...
Oh, I'm below. Oh.
Still could be dangerous.
Oh.
Well, not covering himself in glory defensively.
Oh, that's a poor ball.
The ball was put into the right area, but no one able to capitalize.
Shit. Oh, what a touch that is.
Well, the focus on many of the back pages coming into today's game, very much on him, taking on his old club and Stewart. Different players react to that in different ways.
Well, Derek, I always felt a difficult plan against my old clubs, especially Arsenal. I just felt so strange. It might well be the same for him today. Hopefully not.
We've got to just calm it down, and we're playing at such a pressure right now. They are playing very well. This is a team without Bailey, Coutinho. Shit.
And after that fantastic effort, it's gone out for a throw-in. Sané delivered into the box after the foul, a chance to contemplate what
yes,
is next,
I know to do
and
it.
The goal from this free kick. And all the credit in the world must go to the keeper for getting
1-0.
Hands on it. So the two teams have switched around and the second half is underway. Well, news coming through of a penalty in one of the other matches, and Alex Scott can fill us in.
Yes, it was a penalty for Millwall, and he's only gone ahead. The score is still 1-0.
The replacement for Matty Cash has actually been very good.
As ever. And a strong tackle. Well, many have wondered if they would get it over the line in terms of the deal. They've succeeded, Stuart.
Well, there's certainly been much needed experience to them.
Fuck!
He's still got the legs to have a real impact. I think he'd do well.
Curtis Jones. Sané.
Oh, what a save.
Delivering it.
Oh. You know what? Mara has to come on, surely.
Not the keeper, but technically good goalkeeping. And really pressing their opponents. And a important interception.
Nice, bastard. Still learning the movement of all these players.
An update from Alex Scott. I believe Alex has been a goal at the King Power Stadium.
Yeah, it's a goal for Leicester City. It was an early cross into the box, and it was a great headed finish. They've pulled one back with 65 minutes play.
Alex keeping us right up to date. It has to be. Well, that was.
How has he missed that?
Well, I'm not sure how he's missed the target from there. That's a poor effort.
Jadon Sancho.
He's through. Mara. Come on, you little beauty. Come on.
Well, let's look at this again. To pick out this
pass, Sekou Mara.
It's inch perfect. And then what a strike. That hit was such a
You absolute beauty.
Here and the ball is moving again.
If I can make him high medium, he could be the next Don.
They're making considerable progress.
See, this is what this series is going to find some hidden gems. If I didn't go to Southampton, I'd never heard of him. Shit.
Say he's done really well here. He's in the right place and then a decent finish. That's a good goal.
Number 7, John McGinn. So on with the match.
John McGinn.
2-1 is the scoreline. What's going to happen next?
Substitution for
Southampton. Well, I'm hearing there's a change to the scoreline at Old Trafford. Alex Scott.
It's another goal for Manchester United. They're back in this now with 79 minutes played. The fans are enjoying what they're seeing here today, Derek.
Many thanks, Alex.
Oh. Ah, you fucker.
And the flag was up in good time. It's offside.
Well, he should have realised that was going to be offside. That's a poor decision to play that pass.
Time for a change then. And the timing was perfect. Ball one. Way up. And whipped into the box.
Oh, you bastard.
Defending to stop them progressing. Boubacar Camara. And 3 minutes of stoppage time, that's what the officials have said.
Come on!
That will be all for this
Come on!
Anyway, it goes down as a Southampton success story. How would you sum this up?
Come on!
Today I thought they looked a good side. They were quick to the ball, they were bright.
We're still learning each other, we're still learning. And going into this Man City game, we needed a win. We were by far the better team. It should have been 2-0. Sekou Mara. What a goat. Right, we've got one more game of this episode to go.
Just a couple of questions for you.
We are mentally strong. We are. We stuck to our task.
Thank you for answering the question.
Brilliant, I think. Can I get Morton? Shit, I've only got 2 mil. Latest rumours, Trent to Arsenal. Varane to Everton. Connor Cody has gone to Monaco. What the hell is this chance window? David Sanchez to Mainz. Matt Target has gone to Bologna. Stefan De Vrij has gone to Dortmund. Okay, we're not getting anyone. Scamacca has gone to Bayern. 74 mil. Fuck me, man. Gabriel has gone to Leicester from... what's it called? Juve. Yeah, keep working on the game. Don't worry about it. Yeah, I was actually wondering when Sané's position change would come along. Actually, does Bombardier actually... It does if he can actually do it, but he's 28, so... I won't expect that anything from that. Yeah, still got a chance. Right. Manchester City. It's going to be a tough game. It is going to be a tough game. We're dark. It could be the first loss of the series. Okay, Mara has to be on the bench. Just for now. Why is it always raining in England? This is our first big test. They've got Ousmane, Dembele, Foden and Haaland. Yeah, this is going to be a tough game. I'm looking forward to it, though. Let's see where we're at.
Ousmane Dembele in the spotlight. 3 goals in his last 3 games. He's in sparkling form. We'll have the action on EA TV. Well, the weather has certainly cooperated.
Right, here we go.
Wonderful conditions here at the Etihad Stadium. I'm Derek Gray in the commentary position.
City have the potential to roll us over and bend us. Bend us over and rip us a new one. That's the expression I was looking for.
And they take on Southampton.
Thanks, Derek. Well, often we talk about the tactics, the individual players, players that are missing, but so often it's the mentality of the players that is key to winning any football game. Which of these teams has the right attitude today is the big question.
A chance to whip it in. Well, he read that brilliantly right at the back. Well, news coming through that the referee has pointed to the spot in one of the other matches. With the details, here's Alex.
It was Everton that was awarded the penalty, but it was...
Oh, forgive me, Alex, what an opportunity!
Oh, I should have finessed it.
Well, that's just a wonderful save. How did he stop that?
And fed in by... Mbolo! Goalkeeper doing his job, getting the touch. The corner kicks keep on coming. And clearing it away. Well read to ease the pressure.
Shit, it's Haaland. It is Haaland.
On Ousmane Dembele, who can change any game with one kick of the ball. Stuart, what do you anticipate seeing from
I can't catch him up.
You know his movement is very clever.
Must be foiling his opponent completely. Well read to win possession back.
Ah, oh, trying to block that pass off.
Holland.
The game is too open right now.
Distributing intelligently. Dembele has eyes for goal. Well, diving magnificently to make sure he got there.
Get that, Jaden.
Short corner it is. Now delivering that deep cross.
Let's go.
A chance to break here. And a goal update to bring you in the Millwall game. Here with
come on, Leroy.
Be on for him here. Well, it was so easy on the eye, that counter-attack, but no reward for them.
Yeah, it was all good until the final effort. It just shows how devastating it can be on the break, though.
I'm fucking fuming. How's he missed the target?
And after that fantastic effort, it's gone out for a throw-in. Well, for understandable reasons in this case, we had to cut off, Alex. Just to confirm, Everton did score in that match. They now lead by 1-0.
But, shit. How did that go in? He's a fucking robot. How did he score that? Oh my god, that guy is huge.
Here's the replay. Watch how he goes past his man with such
this is disgusting. This is. Pace, but he's still got so how?
Just look at the strength he shows to hold off the defender and still get his shot away. That's a really good finish.
Well, back underway, and 1-0 it is. Let's see what happens next.
Shit. As soon as, like, City have got it, it's take bloody ages to get it back. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I don't believe this. It's not over. It's not over. Oh, that's a poor pass.
Now with Silva. Sloppy there, Bernardo Silva. Bodies forward and the break looks on. And he's in. And oh, it's in.
Fucking got one back. It might be a City reject.
Well, just look at this again. The counter-attack is so impressive.
He's come back. What a clinical to try and haunt them.
He hits it with such power. That's a good goal.
Right. We made our own mistakes in that two goals. We're not out of it. We're not out of it.
So back underway and an intriguing second half in prospect. Well, something has happened in the Millwall game. Alex Scott has the information for us.
It's another for Everton. They're ahead by two now. With 40
oh, hang on, Alex. Big chance here.
Fucking get in there, Curtis.
Unbelievable stuff.
Come on.
They're right back in this.
Why can we not come back in it?
Well, here you can see it again. Good run, great strength, and a composed finish under pressure. That's a top-class goal.
Well, it has taken a Herculean effort for them to get back to level pegging under these trying circumstances. Haaland. Well, slightly off target.
That's right.
That'll be a throw-in.
Choose the right option. Choose the right option.
And apologies to Alex for having to cut her off. To confirm, Everton did find the net in that game, and the lead at the moment is 2-0. Coutinho, real chance. Oh, it's astonishing! One of the greatest comebacks you're ever likely to see. And now the question is, can they see
not
this
bad.
Out?
Well, here's the goal again, and it's a really nice ball to put in through.
Great ball by Filippo.
The chance is outstanding.
And on his right foot, he scores.
He really does hit this with power. That's an excellent goal.
So the action continues, and City looking to offer a swift response. Can he finish this? And fired against the crossbar.
That was just pure brute force. They're actually going long. Ah, shit.
Well, Chelsea have been busy in the transfer market, and the contract
situation has been ironed out. I didn't even make him come out then.
Could see him in action pretty soon, Stuart.
Well, the fee is reported to be around about £60 million, which is a lot of money, but I think it's worth
it. Shit. Right, come on, let's make some subs. It's got to be Mara on, doesn't it? It's got to be Mara.
He's going to be under huge pressure, of course, but I'm sure he'll be able to cope with it.
Dembele. Teammates in the middle. And they couldn't quite muster a real threat.
Nice. Well out.
Jadon Sancho. Now can they counter clinically?
I think he's on. Ah. Oh.
Vital interception here, and a goal update to bring you in the Millwall game. Here with the information, as always, is Alex.
It's another goal for Everton. Nice build-up play, and when the space opened up, boy, did he take it well. They're now three ahead with 73 minutes on the clock.
And not cleared away properly. And
fuck!
And the second time of asking, just what was required.
See, that's the thing. 3-0, they could be celebrating 10. Oh, we've got back into this. But,
well, as you can see,
no, that's champions mentality, that is. That came from our mistake again.
Well, another equaliser. What a topsy-turvy game this has been.
Substitution for Southampton. Coming off
just
the
10 minutes remaining here.
Jadon Sancho.
Hudson-Odoi. And they're on the front foot, looking for a winner near the end of this game. Well, really lacking composure, and he couldn't beat the keeper.
Well, that's a big moment, and he's completely messed it up.
No, not enough.
Not high quality defending. Out of play it goes.
Nice.
And it will be a throw in. A change in the offing for City. Woodburn.
Number four, Calvin Phillips.
The cross is on. Can he put them in front?
No, I messed it up.
But brilliant defending. And there is the referee's whistle before. Even Steven here.
We didn't lose.
We weren't triggered to goals.
Ah, I'm trying to walk in. I should fucking shoot. Plus the chances we had in the first half as well.
Outstanding individual performances. I really enjoyed that one.
This one, again, I should have just finessed it. I panicked because it's City. But two assists for Briel, two goals for Leroy, assist for Felipe, goal for Curtis. Yeah, it wasn't our day in front of goal, but we can take massive positives from this game. We made City really work for it. I'm happy that we didn't lose. Of course, we were 2-0 down, but we went 3-2 ahead and we made some mistakes, which is fair. Right, now that we have got up to the next game, let's have a look at the squad hub. So, only one clean sheet for Gavin. Good name. Go on, Gavin. But one clean sheet out, one for Loris, but it was against Crawley Town, so there's a bit of a difference. Top goal scorer is Mara, with 3 goals in 3 games, but obviously 2 of them are in the cup, so we need to obviously, say that. Jadon has 2 and 4. Leroy has 2 and 4. Interesting to note, though, also that no assists on both of them. Brill does have two goals, which both have been headers from corners, so we'll obviously rectify that. I'm getting used to him, but he's got three assists, which is nice. One goal, two assists from Curtis Jones. That's nice. Obviously, we're not going to be scoring the same amount of goals as we were scoring in the MLS. That is just a given. But yeah, like, Hudson-Odoi scored in the opening day. Lack of assists right now. Rian Brewster, one goal in four. One goal, two assists. Top assister is Briel and Felipe. So Felipe is still doing his job. But anyway, guys, that is going to wrap up another episode of The Greatest. If you guys have enjoyed, be sure to leave a like and turn next time. Goodbye.